Ladies and gentlemen, hello and welcome back to the Shanghai Dota 2 Open Season 2. We're going to be taking a look at the final match of the evening. This is going to be LGD Forever Young facing off against CDEC Gaming. I'm Lyrical, joined as well by Aosin. It's currently 5:45 a.m. in the morning, which is what a.m. means. And we're here on the west coast of the U.S. Aosin, how are you doing? Are you still with us?
Yeah, I'm good. You know, got my coffee. It's early in the morning. It's pretty good.
Keeper. We've been at it for a little while now and get to see some brand new drafts. My goodness gracious. Zhao Wei's got a new plan and it involves Keeper of the Light and Phantom Assassin. I think that means Double Dagger is going to be coming out. What do you think about this opening in response to the Drow Ranger pickup from CDEC?
I mean, I like it for sure. It's a Phantom Assassin, you know. Blink strike right on top of her, and I guess they must be really confident in this setup, I guess, because like I said, everyone has different ways of dealing with the Drow Ranger, and this is their answer to it, so we'll just have to see how they run it. Dire team
ban. In response, CDEC are going to take the IO for themselves. You know, we'll talk a little bit, just briefly, for anybody that happened to miss it, about some of the games that we saw earlier on tonight. There was Newbie taking off Vici Gaming. They were able to bring them down, and then they did move on in the upper bracket a little bit further on, and they ended up taking down Ehome after the fact. So a lot of stuff came out in the line, and now as we're moving forward into this next set of games here, we did see Newbie kind of own with a Drow Ranger strategy. Do you think that's something that CDEC can repeat? Is that something that LGD Forever Young need to be aware of? Is like, you know, this hero's early pushing ability?
Well, Drow Ranger has reached that stage where every team has to know what's up when it comes to Drow Ranger. Every team has definitely practiced it and practiced against it. And like I said, when it comes to the current metagame, it's literally Drow Strat versus anti-Drow Strat. And Keeper of the Light, Phantom Assassin is their answer to it. I mean, obviously they still have three more picks, but Keeper of the Light aside, PA is definitely one of the heroes that can deal with Drow Ranger.
Okay. Well, as far as other bans that come out, the Puck, the Storm Spirit, all those ranged heroes that cause issues, but CDEC are going to take away the Sand King and the Slardar. Roche is always something that's also really important for any of these early pushing strategies. Do you think that LGD Forever Young need to think about a hero where they're capable of taking Roshan themselves? Anything stick out to you in that, or anything you'd hope to see out of them as their next few picks?
I mean, with a PA, you can definitely do Roshan at a fairly early stage when it comes to Roshan. And even though you're against a Drow lineup, I mean, Keeper of the Light's really good at you know, spamming out waves and stuff like that. So in terms of fighting them at towers in the early game, just with Keeper of the Light alone, it enables them to possibly put up a fight, I would say.
Okay. I just got dropped out of Dota 2. The server kicked me out for a second. So hopefully...
Well, LGD just picked up Timbersaw.
Okay. I saw the Timbersaw, so hopefully this will come back up and we'll be all fine and dandy. Hey, all right. Dota 2 is starting again. Sorry about that, guys. I don't know exactly what happened there. Occasionally there are issues with servers, but hopefully we don't have any more of them.
Amiibo?
All right. I'm back in. You can't trick me. I know your ways.
just making sure.
All right, well, Timbersaw taken out as well. Another hero that's great at being able to spam out waves and also take advantage of that nice little chakra magic cooldown reduction. Timbersaw is pretty sick for that.
I mean, that might be one of the reasons why they picked Caudle too, is because they had Timbersaw in mind. And as a Timbersaw, you do not want to deal with that mana leak. Even though it's nerfed, you still don't want to deal with it.
Yeah. That's a bit of a problem indeed. Yeah, it's something that you would need to be a little bit concerned about if they did happen to have it on CDEC's side. And now for them, is there anything that stands out to you as other ways to deal with the Timbersaw? I mean, I feel like it's a hero that you really do have to game plan against just because of how dominant he can be in the laning stage and, you know, against other melee cores. I feel like they're kind of off the table.
Well, it's a little rough for CDEC right now to think of a way to deal with this Timbersaw because they already showed their Wisp and their Drow. Well, I mean, this first of all, this tri-lane is capable of dealing with Timbersaw, but ideally, I don't think you want to put your Timbersaw against the three heroes because he's going to end up with absolutely nothing for the longest time, and he's not one of those heroes you want to, you know, buy an Iron Talon on and jungle with. So I would assume that LGD should be giving Timbersaw either mid or the safe lane, and they might be running an aggressive tri lane.
Okay. Yeah, I guess aggro tries with PA are kind of a pretty common thing. And I mean, does double Stifling Dagger, in theory, it sounds nice to be able to throw the Chakra Magic on PA and then, you know, you get two daggers or at least two daggers in quick succession. Is that really that valuable, though, in the early stages of the game?
Unfortunately, it's not going to be early enough for that to come. In order for that to happen, you kind of have to have Stifling at either level 3 or 4, and Chakra Magic also needs to be at least, I believe... Actually, sorry, Stifling Dagger doesn't matter at what level, it's always 6 seconds.
Yeah.
It's Chakra Magic that has to be leveled. So until the Chakra Magic comes out to maybe level 3 or 4, it's still going to be 3 seconds or so until you get your second dagger out. So it's not going to be that big of a deal because I don't think you want to level your Chakra Magic all the way as your first skill. Mm-hmm. You kind of want to have a mix and match, so... Not too big of a thing in the early stage.
Wow, an LGD Forever Young. Radiant team taking that Walrus from up north. They're going to run it. Man, again, another hero that's kind of an interesting look. What do you think his role is going to be in this game? We haven't seen him around all that often.
Well, I think this kind of cements that aggro tri lane, because I think Tusk is very, very good against these heroes. Like... If anyone gets caught out, like by the Ice Shard, it's game over for them. They're just dead.
And the Clockwork is also going to get taken now. You know, I'm going to say, I feel like I'm going to sound like a broken record here, but I keep on talking about this Chakra Magic cooldown. Tusk, Walrus Punch, one time, and then, you know, you get a second one 6 seconds later. Granted, that's going to be level 16 for him, which isn't going to come, you know, very soon, but... Something else to think about. There's a few abusable things there. But what do you think about the Clockwork pick?
I guess it's kind of like... Honestly, I would prefer a Void, since it's not banned out. Templar but assessment. This must be something that they've been practicing, and it's probably something he's more comfortable with. It's also very good against Timbersaw because, you know, that Battery Saw makes it so that it's very difficult from the Timber Chain away.
Well... We'll see how this goes. We've got a Templar Assassin as the last pick, and then Dragon Knight as well. Not completely what I would have expected, but to me, when I'm looking at Forever Young's draft, it looks like they have a lot of heroes that are great at team fighting, and then Dragon Knight's just supposed to be that bulky core to take towers.
Well, it is super playing it. I was actually casting a lot of LFY with Lumi last week, and we watched them play a lot of different games, and we've come to the conclusion that watching this LFY team is probably the most entertaining out of all the teams because of how they play now. Xiao8 forces his whole team to just fight nonstop, and I can almost guarantee you there's going to be probably 20 kills in the first, like, 10 minutes.
Oh my god, I'm so excited. Please don't lag out on me, Dota 2. It looks like it's clearing up a little bit. That was just that early start to it, but Tusk, sort of notorious for his first blood attempts. I will say that it looks like they smoked maybe a little bit early. I don't know if they'll get to any heroes by the time that smoke wears off. We'll see. But what do you think about their early first blood kill potential? Do you think they find anybody here?
Oh, definitely. One dagger into a snowball, goodbye.
Are they going to spot him out?
CDC is not going to walk into their own jungle. I think they realize they're scoping it out.
There's a couple of pings. I couldn't tell if that was Venge's pings or if that was a Timbersaw ping. But now they should... they didn't quite get vision, it looks like. Yeah, they're not moving over here, though. Everybody's playing super safe. I think CDEC scattered it out, yeah.
So I'm fairly certain this is the tri-lane, like I mentioned. Timbersaw is going to go 1v1 against the Clockwork, which is very, very good for the Timbersaw, in my opinion. I think it's a pretty good matchup for him. But Clockwork always has that threat. If you misplay even a little bit, I think Clockwork can kill you if you mess up.
Okay. We'll see if they're capable of making those nice Cogs plays to drain the mana and then eventual the battery is solved. But The early bounty runes picked up. Super should have a relatively okay time in this lane. That's a question. With the Drow Ranger aura, how great is this lane going to be for the TA?
I think it's going to favor him very, very slightly, but he can't really, in the end, he can't really do too much against the Dragon Knight. I think a Dragon Knight will farm just fine. He'll probably out-CS him by a little bit, but not that much.
Okay. The early little trading hits here. There is a little bit of lag. I might try a quick reconnect if that's okay. Would you care to do some Radio Dota? Tell me if we happen to miss anything while I'm reconnecting to this.
Just some tri-lane shenanigans going on. I missed Illuminate. He does pick up Illuminate as his first skill. Both sides are playing it very carefully right now. Oh, another Illuminate coming out. Hits on both of them. Damn, that did a lot of damage. Both of them ending up taking about 150 damage each. And October has to blow his first salve.
Well, unfortunate there. Yeah, there's another double Illuminate that comes in and taking a little bit of damage here.
I think a little bit is understating it. November just took 300 damage from two abilities, so...
Oh my god, are they playing... Okay, so CDEC have changed their names so that it's all built around September. It's September, October, November, February...
Yes, I forgot to mention this because, like I said, we casted a DPL. I casted DPL with Lumi last week, and this is now... CDEC is now known as the month team.
That's great. I love it because it was June that joined them as well, right? So then, since they already had June and September, they changed the rest of the names of their players. That's great. Love that. Well, how have you, if you like the way that CDEC have been playing in the previous game that you've been able to watch with them?
Got it. It was LGD's team that we fell in love with because every game they've played in, they have just nonstop been fighting every single game they played in. We watched them play like six games, and all six games, it was like well over 100 kills every game.
Okay. Well, Zhao 8, at least for now, keeping his eyes on that rune, was able to secure it, and June is now going to rotate in. I don't know if he can really contest Yao's farm here, though. He's going to throw out a couple of those rocket flares and get whatever experience he possibly can out of that lane. But so far, Dragon Knight's been able to have a really good time. 14-3 for him. So not bad at all.
Yeah. Like I said, the matchup is not bad at all. But one thing to point out is that...
Oh, Zhao Wei, barely going to be able to walk away with that one.
One thing to point out is that DK is Super's hero. Like, this is his hero. Lumi actually pointed out that Super has been... You know, Super's really good, but he really shines when he's playing DK. Like, every game to play DK, he just owns them.
October again, taking a blast to the face. Is it just his, like, laning phase that's really good, or maybe his play, like, in mid-games, the decision he makes? What is it that stands out for him on this hero?
It's pretty much everything. Like, he does really well in his laning phase. Oh,
I missed the first blood down there. Drow Ranger goes down to the PA, and suddenly in a little bit of trouble, slowed down for the moment. Can they find October? Couple seconds cooldown, but he gets the salve off.
Poor Wisp. He's been salving away. He's eaten so many salves. Oh man, that dagger hurts so badly with one light stone.
Hard life, indeed. And gonna keep on taking the harassment. This lane is just all about the spam, and you can see that no points really given away for Mana Leak right now for the Coddle. He actually doesn't have a clarity right now, but he'll be able to Chakra Magic back up again shortly.
The sad part too is that no one can buy their wands from the side shop. The lane is always pushed up. No one can reach the side shop, and no one has money when they die to buy the dagger.
Would you say that was sort of a mistake on the side of CDEC that they didn't think to come to the lane with the wands, or what do you think?
I mean, I don't think you can afford to buy a wand at the early stages, but at this stage, you should definitely have one. And I mean, they're not getting anything out of the lane, and no one's really buying anything because everyone else is using the courier.
Zhao 8, understanding the draft and the spam is going to be real, not to mention the fact that Tusk now has an arcane rune, so 60 mana for this 60 damage spell. It's a pretty good ratio for him as long as he's got it up and online. Very frustrating to deal with indeed, and still up here in the top lane, Timbersaw is getting the better end of the deal in the clockwork as well.
Now that TA has gotten a few more levels, it's getting a little harder for Super. Oh man, he's eating a lot of splash damage.
Yeah, and that, of course, ignoring through all the nice bit of armor that this hero is known for, does still get the really good regen, so 6 regen per second. Might even end up gaining another point in that in a bit, but that's frustrating. I gotta say, this bottom lane, though, is where all the action is just... I mean, it's constant. Even though he doesn't have, like, the double dagger immediately, the fact that they've got 2 points means that it's still a cooldown reduction of 4 seconds, so you can dagger, and then 2 seconds later, another dagger. It's rough.
Oh, they found their ward. That's actually a very, very...
Oh, mid lane, though. They found Febby. The damage over time's coming in, and they find the kill. Dragonite takes down that TA mid. That little bit of help from Zhao 8.
Yeah, this is one of the strongest things about the aggro tri-lane. They're just holding their supports in place. They can't do anything because they don't exactly want to sack their drow. Oh, missing that hook. Really unfortunate.
Oh my god, Caudle finds the kill on Avenge. Just a quick stun again. He had Dragon Tail still up and Dragon Form on super, so easy kill for him. Man, LGD Forever Young are really dominating this early game.
Oh no, October.
Oh god. Oh,
Monet doesn't find him.
Stand
he's waiting for him to come out.
He's looking. November is here. They might realize he's in the area, but don't want to go for it as of yet.
There's nothing they can do. They're trapped. Monet is just dancing around. He knows that he can't leave.
November's like, see you later, scrub him out of here. I don't want any of this.
Oh, is he going to spot him?
Oh, nice tether away. All right, well, they're done. They are sacking this tower. This tower is going to go down pre 10 minutes, and yeah, there's no other heroes in the area. It's time to party.
They just can't fight him. This is like impossible for them to fight because they don't have the damage. They can't burst a PA that has blur.
Now Drow Ranger's picked up that Quelling Blade again and is going off to farm some jungle creeps. It's a hard life. Is she going to get an Iron Talon? November might get an Iron Talon.
I feel like this is probably going to be Aquila.
Yeah.
It's going to be an Aquila, but... Nope. You were right. Here comes the Iron Talon.
Are you kidding me? Oh my god.
This is how desperate their situation is.
Oh no. Game is very hard. And Iron Talon jungling Drow Ranger.
In case you guys didn't know, this is how you jungle on Radiant. This is the Radiant Cliff jungling that's equivalent to the Dire side one near the top rune.
Oh my god. That is a rough life right now. Well, alright, how does CDEC recover? Is that it? Is that like what their hopes and dreams are depending upon? Is Drow Ranger farming this medium camp?
Well, Drow is just doing whatever he can. Just, you know, this is all he can get. So right. He has to do this until the Wisp gets his level 6 and Clockwork starts making plays happen, and TA probably needs to finish at least like one item, whether it's the Blink or the Desolator. Like, they have to wait for these items to get online, because until then, they're not going to beat this PA or this DK.
Man, what a great draft. This was, like, incredibly strong. This early tri-lane, very effective. You've got the spam that's constantly coming. The one downside is that we're not seeing a transition out of it too much. This is going to be a smoke gank where they possibly try and find a kill. Level 7 is on Clockwork, so they can probably take somebody down here.
Yeah, a lot of this CDEC lineup relies on this Clockwork making plays happen, because while they're doing this, you have to remember, this is a free farming Timbersaw, and you do not really want to deal with a free farming Timbersaw.
Oh god, he's actually... could have one of the components of Bloodstone, and man, Monet just all on top of it, realizes that they're ganking him, and they're not going to find him. Back behind the tier 1 tower, vision was available, and I mean, I don't think that they spotted him here. They were smoked up, but whatever the case may be, Monet dodges the gank, at least for now. But looks like
I think that's just good game sense, because they do have a deep warden, and no one passed through it. No one's farming the top lane, it's just a TA in mid, so you have to assume that something is up.
Yeah, I'm going to head back again as soon as the rotation comes back in. Shows for a second, but they are not going to be able to find this. And they should just get out of there. I don't think they find that kill. Meanwhile, the smoke ain't coming in from LGD Forever Young. This one might bear more fruit, as September has already taken the Chakra Magic from Yao.
LFY do have to be slightly careful with this, though, because it's right underneath the tower. If they dive too far, people can rotate.
Oh, the shards find him. September. It feels rough. That's a rough one. That's a kill, and that's going to be a tier 1 tower gone. Oh my god, this game is hard. Radiant's top tower is under attack.
All right, I take that back. They had no intention of fighting. They're way too weak.
Now, 5,000 net worth lead at 10 minutes in. Getting
five. How do you fight at this point? Your wisp is level 3. Your venge is level 4. It's 10 minutes in. Like, normally when this happens, the other support's like really leveled, but both of them, level 3 and level 4, they cannot do anything like this.
Drow almost has treads, but I don't think that means she's going to be able to fight. Like, I don't know. Dragonlance seems to be the big item. It feels like it's all of their hopes and dreams on Febby here in the Clockwork, but they haven't been able to find a kill with Clockwork, and I'm just not sure if Febby's going to be able to give enough.
Damn. You must be so tired. You are mixing these players up left and right.
Did I say February?
All right.
I don't know who these guys are.
It is June on the Clockwork. Don't forget that.
June on the Clockwork.
I don't believe you. It is 6 a.m. We have been at this for a very long time. It is very difficult. And Febby is the player on MVP.
All right. Okay. He says, look, they've got February in their name, all right?
It is confusing, but we have to be able to differentiate, though.
Oh, my God. This game is also just immensely clowny. You got five heroes grouped up here behind the Tier 1 tower mid. I don't know what exactly they're trying to accomplish. CDEC feels just all kerfuffled at the moment.
They are, I mean, like I said, they don't have any levels. They don't have any way of fighting. Even if you manage to catch one person with Clockwork, you are going to lose a lot of people in return if you try to commit to it. So they really, really have to wait for this Wisp to hit 6, ooh, and he's only level 4.
This might be their comeback potential. Oh, God, but now they've got everybody in the area. Not Febby is getting chased down, the TA in some trouble. She's going to be able to get out of there, though. They've got the Invis rune. Said not that time.
Oh, she's going to find Riccardle.
There's a kill potential.
She missed
there.
The meld. Oh no, she missed the meld.
Oh, that hurts. That really hurts. And now moving in towards the mid lane, LFY taking down the tier 1 tower. Are fortified. This is rather rough.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Nothing is going their way. That was a free kill. And he missed the meld. And he knows it's too late. I can't kill him anymore. I have to get out because it's not worth dying for that toddle.
All right, jump back in. Clockwork Hook onto Super. He's a rather tanky fellow, though, and trying to bring him down. They get the gust as well. The snowball, turn around, swap back in. Super's still doing damage. Meanwhile, the Timber Saw showed up. Oh my god. They're going to be able to rip them apart, I think. Well, maybe not. Monet needs to blink out of here. They've already lost the Dragonite, but three heroes dead from CDEC. That might still be worth it. Not if they lose this TA, though. Zhao 8 is still in the area. They're trying to figure out who they want to go on. June is available. They're going to be able to catch him. There's the Snowball 4. Chakram as well, and they pull him back in for the kill. So four dead in the mid lane. Feb's still here. TA. And we'll be fine. That's a 7-1 now. This game is feeling very hard for CDEC to get anything done.
This is what I'm talking about. Like, they hook one person and they're so far behind that if they commit, they're gonna lose a lot in return when they commit, and that's exactly what happened. They killed Super, sure, but you lost three people in return.
Well, Yao now almost Bloodstone completed. Just kind of getting whatever he wants in this game, and they don't really have anything to control him. I mean, Gust is pretty okay, but I don't know. It's feeling like this game is LGD Forever Youngs to lose.
They do. I mean, you can never count on a Drow strat, though, that's for sure.
Yeah.
I mean, this Wisp, it's almost there. Once he gets 6, they might be able to make pickoffs happen with this Clockwork. But LFY, you know, very experienced captain, they know that once this Wisp hits 6, they're probably going to start their changing up their map movements. They probably won't split up as much and maybe try to bait out some relocates and that kind of stuff. So we'll see.
If definitely a possibility, but tier 1 tower is starting to drop low. TA takes a dagger to the face, slowed Radiant's slightly, but be able to walk away. Deso's completed. There's a lot of damage potential there. You just need to find your opening, and they managed to do that to be in a little bit of a better spot. Meanwhile, the jump through found the drow. She does have Gustaville. Well, Chocom goes out, just barely gonna miss the drow ranger, and looks like LGD Forever Young want to start to think about pressuring this tower. Maybe not. Now the rest of the side of CDC is here.
This was the biggest issue about CDEC's draft. Like, they rely so much on this clockwork setting up for them. And one, he didn't really find much. And two, while he was, you know, looking for kills to set up, Yao was just free farming. And now you have to deal with a timber saw that has bloodstone and a plate mail at 16 minutes. Like, how do you kill him?
Yeah, that's not going to be an easy one. Man, he is going to be so tanky, and like, it's all magical or all physical damage pretty much coming out from CDEC. Is Deso enough to make the difference? Like, is that going to allow them to bring down the timber, do you think?
Oh, here it comes.
Possibly. Relocate gang coming in. They catch the hookshot onto Yao. Can they bring him down, though? Push back as well with the cogs, but he just destroys the IO. Oh, and June, I don't know if he's going to be able to bring him down. They do find the kill finally. So that's Bloodstone charges. That's a problem. LGD Forever Young lose the most farmed hero on their team.
Yeah, that was definitely not worth it for Yao. I guess he kind of just forgot.
Oh, swap back now, Zhao 8. It's going to snowball, but he might still be dead here. Yeah, they get him in the cogs. Now the turnaround, Walrus Punch as the Blade Mail comes out. Nicely played there by by June, and now also in a little bit of trouble. Monet being brought low, not dead as of yet. Timbersaw goes through, but he gets stunned as he tried to throw out the Chakram. Is not going to kill off the Vengeful Spirit. She dies to Super instead. But again, CDEC taking these fights on their terms. They're making it work.
You are going to have to be on your own for a moment because my Dota just crashed.
Uh-oh. That ain't good. So, I mean, in the matter of seconds, what was looking great for LGD Forever Young, Timbersaw has 5 Bloodstone charges. This has gone terribly for LGD throughout the past couple of minutes here. I mean, as far as, you know, again, you're obviously gone from us for the moment, but, for Timbersaw, you know, you depend upon that Bloodstone regeneration so much for your skills, and sometimes you'll see Timbers go back afterwards for something like a Yule Scepter to allow them to, you know, keep up the regeneration rates. With this plate mail, is Timber going to have enough regeneration with only 5 Bloodstone charges?
Unfortunately, it's still, like, kind of early. I mean, as long as he doesn't, like, expend everything farming, he'll always have enough to fight, especially with the Coddle to help him out with that. He can always, you know, Chakra Magic him or something like that. So it's definitely not the worst for him, but one thing I did forget to mention is that while they were our favorite team to watch, this happens very often. They will have no issues winning the early game, and then all of a sudden everything goes downhill because they mess up somehow in the mid game.
See if they can solve those problems. Man, Monet just goes in onto November there. Isn't going to be able to find the kill yet. Looking for the crit. Actually gets swapped away. And, oh, Timbersaw's there as well. They throw the chopping through onto 2. 5 still in the area for CDEC. But LGD Forever Young, they've got their eyes on this tier 2 tower. They want to take it. Radiant's bottom tower has fallen. There we go. I mean, still the problem I'm seeing is this TA. She's 10,000 net worth at this point and has Blink Dagger, Deso, and 1,600 gold towards her next item. Snowball for June. Not going to be able to catch him inside the cogs. He does get caught by the Chakram. Super gets the stun. They are thinking about a swap back in 1 second. It's available. Yao taking a lot of damage. Might be in trouble there. Can they find the kill? But the counter initiation comes in for Monet. Still taking a lot. There's the belt strike. Destroys. They actually catch onto the TA with the hookshot. Now Super in trouble after the pushback with the Kaj. LDD Forever Young. Zhao Wait. He's going to drop too. Triple for the TA. She wants more. Come back here, she says, for the Coddle. But I don't know if she's going to be able to catch him. She gets there after the four staff with the slow. And the Chakra Magic, another blink in 1 second. TA is hungry, but not going to find it as of yet. Yeah, she's just going to instead go for the tier 1 tower, but man, CDEC an explosion. They're making it work.
Dude, this TA is enormous. One thing that LFY forgot to do was deal with that ancient stack, and they just built it up, waited for Templar Assassin to reach a level where she could clear it out, and all of a sudden you have a Deso on a blink, and it is just insanely strong when you have these items at an early stage, because no one's going to survive that. It just takes 2 to 3 shots and everyone dies.
Well, and now we see the change in net worth. What was a 7,500 gold lead at right around that 16-minute mark has now switched back over to about even point in CDEC. I mean, I guess this is just the patch where you can fight your way back into the game.
I mean, like I said, you can never count out a Drow lineup. Even if you're far behind, with only a couple of items, you can still do an enormous amount of damage. And while they were severely behind, the TA never fell behind. He was always, you know, ridiculously far. And with that, you know, just takes a couple of mistakes and 2 to 3 shots, you start losing people left and right on LFY.
I mean, TA right now has 300 damage when refraction charges are up, and she gets that bonus damage. BKB now completed. This is going to be a problem. The jump forward from Super is going to be able to get the stun onto June, but the swap away, and that should keep him alive for the moment, and then relocate it out. All right. I wonder, do they want to fight this? I mean,
they definitely should fight this, because they know the Wisp has to come back. They're going to lose the Wisp for nothing.
Oh, they've got the reduced damage there onto Super. Pull him back in. TA ready to jump. Is going to be able to find it. Oh, a good Walrus punch, keeping her controlled, but the BKB has already been popped now. Brings Monet very low. He's not going to die, though. Those stick charges saving a life. So they lose the Wisp, but take down the Timbersaw in exchange. Well, worth it for CDEC.
On the bright side for LFY, at least, they did manage to force the Templar Assassin to use his first BKB charge. So, you know, for a 10-second BKB, only losing your Timbersaw isn't the worst thing.
And looking at this, I mean, Timber's going to have to go back now for a Yules. He can't deal with it. He's down to 4 Bloodstone charges after the suicide. This game
I think he's going for the Lotus Orb. That's okay. One way to deal with it.
Oh, the jump forward. If they could find this kill on TA, it'd be so big. But there's the catch with the tether. She should be fine after this. And now looking for a turnaround. Zhao 8 again hits with that Walrus punch. And can they find anything else here? Looking for Super. One right click, already dealing a bit of damage. Look at the amount of damage she does over there to the Caudle. And now in the Meld Strike, fine for the moment. As November going for the catch, a really good hook with the Clockwork push back onto 2 with the Cogs as well. Is she going to be able to find the kill on a Monet? Looking for it. It's going to get it with the Meld Strike. Mega kill streak. And they are destroying Yao's down again. Double kill. The TA is just on a roll. My God, she's doing a lot of damage.
This is the new meta. Lose lane, buy Iron Talon, come back with Drow, no problem.
You heard it here first, guys. Iron Talon Drow, it's the way to win. Just give your TA the damage. Dire's middle tower has fallen. Oh my goodness. And now,
look at this TA. He does 270 damage without refraction. He does 350. Oh wait, sorry, there's a Banjara too. He does 360 damage.
Oh,
how do you
man.
Fight that?
Now, I mean, Super is here. They go into Dragon form. I don't know if they want to take this fight. Sep is going to take a bit of damage, but they just relocate him out. Everybody else is TP'd away. They're gone. TA is still farming. Does need to be a little bit careful, but I don't think that they really want to fight her. They probably lose the IO here, though. It's gone.
Well, they saved their Venge, at least. The Venge was level 11, so I guess they lose a little bit less.
And, I mean, it's another Bloodstone charge for Yao. He really needs them at this point. His farm has fallen way off since that initial great start that he got, and it's just all been the TA show.
Feels bad. 4 Bloodstone charges.
It's a rough life.
He has 600 gold off of the Lotus Orb, but...
Oh, hook shot again, and the Force Staff to counter it out. Oh my God, Connell made a good play, but June made a better one. Zhao, 8, eat your heart out. That was wonderful. And precise, homing in.
Well, now we see why he picked himself Clockwork. This guy clearly knows what he's doing on Clockwork. He knew that Forstaff was coming and waited for it, and Forstaff to chase him. That was some sick plays.
You love to see that stuff, and he's going to have an Aghanim Scepter soon. He's been making those hook shots all game. I mean, I guess that's something else that we should mention. It's June is making plays for his team as well. It's legit. And now, I mean, the question remains. You've got the PA with the Vanguard and Odesso, so she can do some damage, but I don't know. Are they going to be able to stand up to this TA?
It's just not enough, unfortunately. She's going to need a lot more than that to deal with people.
Oh, another hook coming out. They found not super.
Like this.
Another push charge. Push back, and they found him. Now he forced us forward. Gonna
oh,
be
my
Wicked
goodness.
They're all going down. Wicked Six Streak. This is a tier 3 tower that's about to fall. They are going to jump forward now, looking for a bit more. Going to be able to bring down Xiao Wei. Double kill for the TA. Don't stop her now. BKB charge used, but I don't think she cares. Eyes on the prize. It's going to be Barracks time. Oh, goodness. You love to see it, and now Silenced Yao gets off the Lotus Orb. Mayonnaise jumps in there as well. The Timber Saw is able to bring down one, but is it going to be enough? Triple kill for her. Oh, just get into range. I think she wants that Rampage and potentially might be able to find it. No, let's turn back around. That's the Aegis down at the very least. Super is going to Armlet Toggle through this. She should be able to jump forward. Armlet Toggles are looking good, but there's the Ultra Kill. Mayonnaise drops down. Oh, no, she's not going to be able to get it. Io, why'd you steal the kill? GG gets called. It doesn't matter. This TA has just run a clinic, taking the old man back to school.
Very, very strange game. I feel like LGD just should have been a little more disciplined, I think. They shouldn't have overextended at such an early stage. Like, sure, they had a huge lead, but it's still really early in the game. And you can't exactly rule out the TA who had, you know, equal net worth to their team. Let's see. I mean, TA was ahead of the entire time. Like, you can't rule out a TA that does 250 damage at level 10.
Oh, what a beautiful performance. You love to see that stuff. They flip. They really just, like, went to town. 10-1-7. Damage done, 16,000. Throughout that fight. Oh my goodness. Beautiful stuff. Aelson, any final thoughts about this game going forward? You said you really like the LGD Forever Young side. I agree with you. They were definitely entertaining and made a lot happen in the early game. What do you think the issue is with them as far as sort of securing that into a mid-game advantage?
They just have to be just a little bit more disciplined. Like I said, like, they had the lead. They just have to work around maintaining it and building it up further. Like, they took a lot of unnecessary risks when, you know, they didn't need to. And as long as they, you know, keep their cool and try not to overextend, they should be fine.
All right. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to be back in just a short second as we come back for the CDEC Gaming versus LGD Forever Young game number 2 here. It's the Shanghai Dota 2 Open number 2. I've been Lyrical, joined as well by Aosin. Feel free to follow us on Twitter if you feel so inclined, as well as all those lovely social media sites that everybody loves to frequent. And of course, be sure to follow the tournament, BTS as well. And we'll be back in just a second. Game number 2 in a minute.